Hello, people of the internet, it's Amanda, and the other day I was watching this series of videos from YouTuber Brian Seeker on how he recasted the cast of the Harry Potter movies. And I was 11 years old when the first movie came out, so it was definitely more of like anticipating every year, like going back to Hogwarts for me every time each movie came out. And so it was a major part of my childhood, and I couldn't really imagine anyone playing some of the most iconic roles in the series, like Alan Rickman as Snape, Maggie Smith as McGonagall. It's just kind of hard to think about that, but as I watched his videos of recasting these characters, gave me an idea as to how that would be like if I were to do the same treatment with some of the J-dramas that I love. Obviously, this is just for fun, so I'm not like, don't come for me if you don't like my choices, but anyways, obviously, if we're talking about J-dramas, classics, OGs, Hana Yori Dango is the first choice. Now, this is quite tricky because I remember when I found out about Hana Nochi Hare in 2018, I was so psyched that they didn't go for a reboot because I feel like the first version of it, especially with the first season, second season, and the movie, it was brilliant in itself. It's my favorite version out of all the different versions that happen in different countries. I love Hana Yori Dango. I think Matsumoto-jun and Inoue-mao's chemistry is just something that, even if there are a lot of like love stories in dramas, their chemistry is just something else. And I absolutely love them. And it's kind of like, I feel like this is definitely something that's challenging that I would want to take on, and it's also kind of fun because I love this series and I see that there are a lot of current Japanese actors and actresses that would probably, I don't know, like it's just an exciting prospect for me. But I was really happy that Hana Nochi Hare happened and it wasn't a reboot, it was a sequel to the original ones. Now, speaking of Hana Nochi Hare, for this particular recasting or fan casting, I wouldn't be getting anyone from that particular series in itself. So think of this as sort of like reimagining what Hana Yori Dango would look like in 2020. I'm gonna be saying this over and over throughout this video, but this definitely was really challenging for me to come up with, especially with how perfect like the actual adaptation of Hana Yori Dango was. But I still hope that you guys enjoy along with me, and so let's go. This video, obviously, I'm gonna focus more on our F4 and our Maki no Chukushi, but then later on I would be quickly running through some of my options regarding the supporting characters as well, but it wouldn't be as detailed in terms of the choosing process like when I explain it later. So with that, I'm gonna start off first and foremost with our mobster slash peacemaker in the group, Akira. I definitely have this sort of like image in my head that he should be someone who has this sort of like very nice, calming facade to him. Like, he's someone that would look like he can have authority over his own friends. He is described as a voice of reason for the F4, and I do feel like it has to be someone that has that kind of like vibe to him, but at the same time has to have charms of someone who can be someone who can charm older women. And so I had two candidates for this particular role. The first one is Kiyohara Sho, who I've seen in Koitsudu recently. And I feel like he definitely has this sort of like sinister, too cool for you kind of look to him, that he can switch from someone being playful and a bit, not really childlike, but more of like have that boyish sort of like rowdiness to him, but then at the same time, like if he flips that switch, he can also have this vibe of, you know, like he can look stern in a way, and that's the reason why I have him pegged as my first choice for Akira. And then another one is Hiyo Miyazawa, which I've seen him in Todome no Kiss, in Kakegurui, and he definitely knows how to nail that sort of like very strict but not really cold facade to him. And I do feel like he can also play, he also has that look that can match up to the suaveness of Akira. And so when I was thinking about who to really put out there, I figured that finally my vote would be for Hio Miyazawa as Akira. Next up is Sojiro, and I find this really fun to cast because he's obviously, like, if Akira is into older women, Sojiro is just the womanizer of the bunch. Like, he has to have this, like, very cool look to him, that he's a playboy, but at the same time he needs to have like a very, like, if he needs to be serious, then he can look serious. We need someone to know how to play that dynamic. And so, again, I did have a couple of options for this one. So, Yokohama Ryusei, I've seen him in many, many dramas. It would be too long if I recount the dramas that I've seen him in. And I've seen him play very nice, very, I don't know, like, very strong-willed type of characters, playboy type of characters, but I've seen him play very nice and sincere and nice guy type of characters as well, and I think he can really pull it off. And then the other one is Sugino Yosuke, who, for some reason, all of the dramas that I've seen him in, Hana ni Kademono, Good Morning Call, everything, he has to have that playboy factor to him that plunges deep into falling in love eventually in the plot. And so these two actors, I feel like, are perfect for the role of Sojiro. But then again, what I want for our, like, five main cast is just to have, like, one character for them in this fan casting. And so after thinking about it a lot, I do feel like Sugino Yosuke would be great at playing Sojiro. Yokohama Ryusei, I feel like he's been in so many dramas. We've seen him with these types of role, like, dynamic roles as well. So I feel like he has enough projects on his plate already. So if this remake is gonna happen, I do feel like Sugino Yosuke is perfect as Sojiro. Okay, so here it is. We're nearing our main three. So, gonna start with Rui first. Now, this one is kind of tricky because obviously the second lead, like, Hanazawa Rui is the ultimate second lead. Like, he caused the entire wave of second lead syndrome. All of his adaptations, whether it be Wachile, whether it be, like, just every version of him is the epitome of second lead syndrome. And so looking for someone who, you know, who would have this sort of, like, very quiet, very, very, very unreadable, mysterious facade to him, but also this kind of, like, kindness and, like, someone who would make us fall in love with the second, like, second lead character, but at the same time, like, it wouldn't be someone who would overshadow the main lead or our Tsukasa. It's definitely a rough thing for me to think of someone who can play this role nicely. So I had three people slated for this. First on my list is Alan Shirahama. And the thing with this is that I think it's because of his character in Daytime Shooting Star that I initially wanted him to play Rui, because he can play that very calm, collected type of character. But then when I thought about it, I feel like he definitely doesn't have that sort of, like, timid look to him. He looks too badass to be Hanazawa Rui. So then again, I scratched that. So my next options came down to two actors. The first one is Kentaro Sakaguchi, and then there's Kitamura Takumi. Now, this was a bit hard for me to decide on because I've seen both actors in many, many movies and dramas, and I feel like both of them can really pull off the Hanazawa Rui character. However, I eventually decided on Kitamura Takumi because I feel like he can definitely play that sort of, like, very timid, very calm and collected type of character, but someone who is also very passionate and very just someone who has that sort of like mysterious charm to him without looking or feeling very foreign. Domyouji, on the other hand, while those seem like very easy decisions, choosing Domyouji, Tsukasa Domyouji, I mean, who can top Matsumoto Jun in this role? No one. So it was really, really hard for me to come up with a casting for him. I do feel like if it's gonna be this day and age, they would have casted Yamazaki Kento or Fukushi Sota in this role. They're not my first choices for these roles because I do feel like they've had their fair share of live action adaptations, and it would just kind of be weird to have them in these iconic roles as well. So I definitely scratched them off, but I do feel like if I'm an executive at TBS, then it's definitely like that's gonna happen. With that said, so who are the people that actually made it into my list? Now, I had a couple of options. I had Yuto Nakajima, I had Nakajima Kento, and I've also had Alan Shirahama, just to balance things out and to see who among them could probably play this role, especially with Matsumoto Jun just really shooting it up there in terms of the standards. I figured that Alan Shirahama, I haven't seen much of his work yet. I feel like it's also because he hasn't been in much, given his really more of an artist than an actor, but I do feel like for the project that I've seen him in, he can play off that sort of like bad boy type of character, but not really to the point that it can inject Domyouji-ness in a sense that there's an innocence or sort of like even ignorance and stupidity to it, much like the Hemingway episodes of Domyouji in the original adaptation. So, Alan Shirahama, I'm so sorry, but I have to scratch you off again. Next is the two Nakajimas, and this one is quite tough because I was like, it can also help because both of them have their respective boy groups, idol groups, so they can sing the theme song if ever. I do feel like Yuto, it's kind of hard to sort of like come up with, like he can play that bad boy type of character, but then at the same time have that sort of like boyish innocence, rowdiness to him as well. But then in terms of projects that really sort of like gave the impression of these types of roles that are very similar to our very own Domyouji Tsukasa, I eventually came down to Nakajima Kento. I'm still now 100% convinced, but I do feel like in this role, he can definitely inject that sort, like he can play very silly characters. I've seen it in Nisekoi, but at the same time, he's also done like very nice, very serious types of characters that really draw on a lot of emotion, which I feel like should have that right of balance if we're looking for Domyouji Tsukasa, someone who can project those kinds of like extreme emotions, but at the same time, sometimes he's just funny as heck. And so I feel like Nakajima Kento would definitely do a great job as Domyouji Tsukasa if ever we're going to like do this entire thing. That's my F4. I even tried to come up with a collage to see as well if they would look good together as the F4, and I do feel like I really have a nice bunch picked out here. So with that, let's move on to our Makino Tsukushi. Now this one is crazy because as soon as I'm thinking of the fan cast, I figured that if Hana Nochi Hare didn't cast Sugisaki Hana, I feel like she would be perfect, like the perfect reincarnation of our Tsukushi Makino. I do feel like that's the reason why she pulled off Oto so well, is because they have that sort of like plain girl vibe, but still can balance between being nice and being badass. And that's why it's so hard to look for someone who can play this character, for someone that can play off that plain girl vibe and balance all these types of things, is definitely more challenging to me than coming up with my F4 for this particular video. Like, I have my list here, and for Tsukushi alone, I feel like I have 7 people listed that I really thought, tried to think of, like, who would I cast for this particular role. And it's definitely crazy. It ended up crazy. In terms of this, I balance it out in a way that I don't want them to be that typical pretty girl. So Komatsu Nana and Hirose Suzu are definitely out of my list. They're the types of girls that you can cast in roles that are, you know, in stereotypically in the material are already pretty girls. So I really want to look for more girls, that more actresses that are often cast in roles that are, that they are treated quote unquote ordinary, even if they're not really, they're really kawaii. So, but let's just go with that particular narrative. Now for this one, a couple of my options were Kawaguchi Haruna, Hashimoto Ai, Tsuchiya Tao, and Ayame Goriki. Now, it was a really crazy process for me as to how I would pick my Maki no Tsukushi, because I feel like it all of these girls, you know, they can play that sort of like nice, that plain girl vibe, but still inject attitude and personality to it. However, Nagano Mei also made my list, but I do feel like it all came down to like two options. So Ayame Goriki and Tsuchiya Tao, I feel like they can definitely pull off that makino-ness to them. And I've seen them do this in various characters that they've done in the past, but going deeper into it and trying to sort of like see the dynamic, especially with the F4 that I fan casted, I eventually went to Tsuchiya Tao as my Maki no Tsukushi of the modern day. And I think one of the reasons as well is because she's done a project with Nakajima Kento before and they pulled off that sort of like chemistry. So that I think that also added as to why I put her in this particular like fan casting. So, but it was really hard for me to choose the characters that I would put, especially for the two main characters of this series, but it was just sort of fun. And I feel like if they're gonna do it, I would stand by my choices that I've said in this particular video. Without babbling, as I mentioned earlier, I'm gonna run quickly through my options as well for supporting characters. So again, referring to my list right here. So the first one that I had, obviously, is Domyouji Kaede, which is Domyouji's mom that in every version, we're all just stressed out about her because she's sort of like the main antagonist here that don't want these two lovers to get together because of class, social status, everything. And it's kind of sort of like hard to find a character again that can play this off nicely, because she has to have this very like nice fancy type of facade to her that is really depicting an iron woman. And so I ended up with two options, Miyazawa Rie and Daichi Mao. I feel like Daichi Mao, as soon as I first saw her in Atelier, I immediately thought of her as an option for Domyouji's mom, even way before I even planned on making this video. Miyazawa Rie, I feel like, is someone who can play both like very nice characters, but at the same time, like someone who can be very stern as well. I feel like both of them can have this like classy vibe to them that is definitely capturing the essence of Domyouji Kaede. Speaking of Domyouji family, I'm gonna move on to Domyouji Tsubaki. And this one, I had a lot of options as well. Now, as I mentioned, for supporting characters, I would throw in the options out there, but I wouldn't really dive deep into picking just one. I have a lot, like I have Kitagawa Keiko, Masa Aya in mind. I didn't really think of a casting for Tsukushi's family, mainly because it was just hard for me to find people as comical actors and actresses that could play off as like parents for the character, and also really have that sort of like image that we've pictured in the original adaptation. However, I did also have ideas for Sakurako. So definitely, aside from Domyouji Kaede, she was the very first antagonist in the series, where which led us to the beautiful confession of Domyouji to Tsukushi that he likes her. And for that, I felt like if I didn't have the rule that I wouldn't get from people from Hana Nochi Hare, I feel like Imada Mio would do well as Sakurako. But then other actresses that I've also fan casted in that role is Ruka Matsuda, Hashimoto Kana, or Eliza Ikeda. I do feel like Kana might be a bit of a stretch here. But I feel like Eliza Ikeda would definitely do a good job as Sakurako, mainly because she can play very nice and timid characters and then at the same time like turn it into a complete 180 as well. And I don't know, I feel like she can definitely add new type of depth to that character, besides just what we saw in the original adaptation of Hana Nochi Hare. Tsuoka Yuki, or Makino's BFF, I had to think of a character, of an actress that would have really good chemistry with Sugine Yosuke as my Sojiro. So I came up with two: Kamishiraishi Mone, which is like the universal BFF for most of the series that we've seen, and Yuna Taira. Now for Yuna Taira, I do feel like she's quite young as compared to like the cast that I listed, but at the same time I do feel like she can definitely play off Yuki's character very similar to the Meteor Garden version, more so than the Hana Yori Dango version. But I do feel like she can definitely play Yuki for this particular series. So yeah. For Madame Okami, I don't know why, but Yuko Takeuchi was the first actress that came into my mind, and she was the only actress that I could picture for this particular role. I didn't think of anyone else, but I would love Yuko Takeuchi to be the Madame Okami. Speaking of characters that I only have one actress in mind, for Monkey Girl or Shigeru Okahawara, I can only think of Tsubasa Honda. I feel like I couldn't think of anyone else that could pull off that sort of like rich girl that's both badass and just, other than her, she's, to me, she's definitely a perfect Shigeru for this particular series, if ever it's gonna be rebooted. Kizuku Toda. So this one, I did have a couple of actresses cast also. So I have Yui Aoi, Misako Renbutsu, and Mary June. Because I do feel like they can definitely have that air of elegance to the top choice definitely would be Yui Aoi for Shizuoka Toda for this particular recast that I'm doing. And then last but not least, quite interestingly, I added this one because he's not exactly a significant character. He just appeared in Hana Yori Dango Season 2 Episode 1, but because he was played by my first love. So I'm gonna be casting Oribe Junpei for this one, which is a character that hostaged to Makino Tsukushi so that he can get back at Domyouji Tsukasa. For this one, I had two actors in mind. They have to be someone who can disguise themselves in the school, much like how Thomas' character was like in this series, but at the same time can also double up as this very cool, very suave model type of character. So obviously, two people I had in mind, Aratama Kenyu and Yoshizawa Ryo. They have played characters wearing glasses before. Obviously, it's not like it degraded their looks in any way, but they've done it with Toma as well, where they just put like glasses on him and then eventually they thought that people would see them as unattractive. But I do feel like because of this, it gave me the impression that they can pull off the Junpei role really nicely. It would also be a good cameo if ever. And both of them, at the flip of a switch, can look very sinister, handsome sinister in a way, which I feel like would definitely give justice to that particular role. With that said, this has been an intensive video, but this is really hella fun for me to do. And I think that maybe, I don't know, in the future, I would fan cast other or recast other J dramas or Asian dramas that I love. But yeah, this is just hella fun to do, and I hope that you enjoyed this with me as well. If you did, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new to my channel and you would want to hear more from me, please hit subscribe. Tell me down in the comments below if you have any other ideas as to how we can recast our other J-dramas, if you agree, disagree with my choices. So I would love to hear all about them in the comments below. Thank you so much for watching this video, and I'll be seeing you again soon in a new one.